Hello and welcome to another session with your host DJ Mox. What's up? We are on our way today. Regular day, regular observations on the road. What else to do? How are you guys doing? Welcome, welcome, welcome everyone. Like any other drive day today. Yeah. Post editing work will be awesome. We generally like to go live stream, but there are a few problems with the Insta and we will discuss that today. Regarding the live streams, first of all, the quality, second of all, the bugginess, third of all, the cutoff limit for the Insta 360 in terms of the live stream timing that it can record up to. So that is another limitation of the Insta. By the company itself, the bugginess of it, oh my god, the application bugginess of it is like phenomenally large. I have to start a live stream. Does it go out? Doesn't it go out? Is it sustainable? Not sustainable? Restarting the devices 3-4 times just to make it sustainable. And then when you get a good live stream, until then, your viewers are already lost to you. It's not like I didn't try it. At times, you can check out the live stream panel to understand how the live streams have been going. I've deleted all the old ones, which are just the short ones that happen to happen, but don't happen really well for like 2 minutes, 8 minutes stream, and then I have to shut it off, etc. So that kind of a situation is also existing with the Insta. And a few more problems that keep happening. I've been talking to the representatives about returning the device. Believe me, I'd rather we'll go simplified with a GoPro, just a 180 view or something like that, you know. Just people, how they be about and stuff and all. I expected this to be much better, much larger, like much better to, enjoy for the viewers as well as for the user. But that's not the case. And believe me, I mean, I'm disappointed as well. The few things the company can do to fix that, but I don't know what is the reason. I know the reasons why that is, and so if they shift the in the development phase, if they shift from the way the codec has been transmitted, for example, we are using VP9 today, YouTube is using VP9, Twitch is using VP9, which is a smaller container for the MP4 container, which MPEG container, I don't know. Must be go talking on top of my head, but the idea is that if it is possible to get to a smaller codec, so then what will happen, we'll get a better quality stream with better encoding and a better quality out there. Their internal capabilities for live streams are only 1280p and not 1080p, so you are effectively getting a smaller quality for for the viewers to view in a bad quality. Yeah, no, a smaller format, good quality, small format, but bad quality in terms of visual fidelity. Not a great quality one, the 1280p. They've actually uploaded that for only reason that they only made that, you know, from a mobile, even if you're doing 3G or 5G or 4G, whatever G you're using, the idea is that it can only send out a signal of, say, maximum of 6 Mbps to 30 Mbps nowadays, and between those speeds, running a proper YouTube situation and, running a constant signal for the so-called live stream becomes a real hassle, and it's a debatable situation that how do we reduce on, first of all. Then comes the part of its heating issue. They said, I spoke to all the protocol, I mean the help desk people and who else, lots of people I've been talking to and communicating with in terms of every day almost I'm with the helpline of the Insta desk, and I keep reiterating to them that, you know, this cutoff limit of just a 30-minute live stream is like a, how would I put it? I don't get words in my mouth. They clip the wings of the device, you know? It's like aiming for Mars but not even landing to the moon. It was like that, in all honesty.
Okay.
Let me just navigate this traffic here. I'm already running late. Yeah. And in terms of video recording, the fidelity is pretty decent. I will myself come to know about how the video recording quality might be when I reach to edit it. And then we will take it from there. But as of now, I presume that the quality is awesome. Hey, side chalne bhai, road pe chalega. People, you know. Mr. Janapriya School Bus. Alright, but lucky for us, we are in time to take that flyover which is going to open up now. Anyway, coming to the other issue, which is obviously the visual fidelity on the device itself for recording purposes is, I believe it's great. That way I have no complaints there. The device is handy. It's pretty neat. But now I will come to know once I check out the video, how the quality of the stream might turn out to be. In terms of, like, now that I'm using the device on a motorcycle clamp and motorcycle listing, which I bought along with it. The idea of me buying the Insta360 was clearly to obviously do motor vlogging. But I didn't expect it to become like a so-called, even though it is a motor vlogging situation, I wanted to live stream while riding my bike along the road and things like that, you know, but seems like it's not going to be a possibility. I'll have to check on the GoPro now. What I'll do is I'll rent out a GoPro instead of buying a GoPro. I'll rent it out. It'll cost me cheaper. I'll rent it out for a week, and then we will decide the pros and cons of live streaming life with these devices. Navigating through traffic. God, I shouldn't be so late. Let's just record a video rather than going live. I expected myself to make this a live session, but I set it all up for making it a live session, but now I don't want to go live because I'm already recording. I might make it live after, maybe because the space on the SD card, I don't have so much to like, record a full length video for an hour or so. You know, honestly, I like the Insta 360, but due to the caveat of it's not doing live streams, it sort of put a frown on my face. I might be sending it back to the company. I just might, unless they actually quickly, you know, do the right things, get the right things into place, maybe increase the limit of that, you know, half an hour limit, 30 minutes only. And it automatically shuts itself off. The app shuts the live stream out. It stops the recording on the phone. I don't know whether Insta itself wants to shut it off, or camera decides to know the time when it started and started recording or doing live and then shutting itself off. Where that mechanism is, I don't know. The remote sensing mechanism is on top or the bottom, I don't understand. Top or bottom, I mean like in the camera or in the mobile. Plus, in the advancements of today's age, I need like two devices to check on my live as well as oh my god, they didn't open the seat. What? They didn't open the bloody flyover today. What the hell? Damn you! Why didn't you open the flyover, man? It's 8:30 already. Anyway, this one looks like a Vic Pillen. Got a shock on the side instead of in the center, like all three have. That's weird as fuck. Sorry, I didn't realize you guys are there. A lot of inner thought processes in the mind. Yeah, coming back to the pros and the cons. Zooming through traffic. A day in the life of Oba. Of me. It's a home.
That's it.
And pitch. Okay, coming back to the another thing that I want to talk to you guys about, I will come to know once I upload the video for editing, is the flimsiness of the accessories. I don't have any idea how these people managed to get such a great video feed, which is, you know what I mean, like, stabilized, you know, very, very, you know, great. Because this, the camera on the bike right now is flimsy AF, man. It's shaky. It's flimsy AF. Instantly moving around. It's just great. I mean, I'll show you once we are hitting traffic and I go for a standstill. I caught the traffic today. I got late. That's why I hit this traffic. If I make it early on the early days, it doesn't. So you see, I'm gonna shake the camera. You see that? This is the constant movement of the device when you are riding. So, especially on the live streams, it might be irritating because it's all shaky. And there is no stabilization involved. There's no internal stabilization for the camera. If it is there, I've not unlocked it yet. I don't know. Oh, there. Oh, God. It's like your head is rolling in your brain. Your brain is rolling in your head. I wanted to do a lot of recordings and stuff, trying to get those awesome shots where I put the camera at the back of the bike and take a 360 shot from there, and you know, like, take a camera view on the top of the helmet where you can see the whole city and things like that. But I mean, I am just sort of either disappointed or scared that, you know, the camera might fall off or something like that might happen, which is why I haven't taken those kind of shots. I don't know how people have the courage to do all that in the other terms, in the real life and all. Okay, today's live is going to be cancelled. We're probably doing live in the evening, but coming back. All right. The traffic part of the city is gone now. It's just all flyovers and good journey now. Something that I can showcase the pull of the bike to you guys. Little bit of the empty roads. Welcome to Hitech City of Hyderabad. All right. Touching the better speeds of the 80s and the 90s now. Look at that. Power to my wings, man. This is the reason why I get out on my bike. This is the reason why I choose to ride. These speeds and these energies is the reason why I choose this.
Feeling.
Dig, 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 dig. Sorry about that. Yeah, please go ahead. That's the life of an Indian. Can just never be satisfied by just chilling and waiting like other people in line. All right, signal is ours. Let's go. Bro, I've not even done the half mode on, bro. I'm still at half mode. Right, let's go. So, how you doing, Hyderabad? How you doing, people? Man. So I had started with something the topic that was the disappointment of the camera. But I guess it's not all that bad in terms of video recording. If I just recorded videos, and I honestly don't think I have the time to sit and edit them. But if I do sit and edit them and pull things out, it might be great to enjoy some vlogging. Maybe I'll give it a shot. Maybe I'll just sit and upload vlogs and see how it goes. But anyway, let's go to the stretch that I am always excited about, where we have the liberty to spread our wings and fly, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Durgam Chiruva Bridge, a bridge that is made on water for us to connect to half of the city. And the bend. Let's go. I've not even put it in the red board. Once I do put it in the red board, then you will see the effect of the real beauty of this bike. We are on an ultraviolet F77. I have got the second Mark II edition right now. And this edition came just a few months ago. I've got the Airstrike, which is the white color Moni. And it's the top end. Costed me around 5.5 lakhs plus some of the extra things. I've got my registration and everything from the company itself. I don't need to really do any hassle free, all registration, everything completed from the company. Soon they will come and put my number plate also as well. And the three modes on the bike, there is its light, combat, and ballistic. And now it's time to showcase you guys the ballistic mode. There we go, ballistic mode on. Let's go. F131. I can't believe I'm gonna do this to a car. See ya, cops. This is the only place in Hyderabad that I am able to do my ballistic mode on. And boy, oh boy, it's an awesome feeling. All right, back to regular driving. Back to the regular days. Chilling in the combat mode. So yeah, telling you about the three modes that we have. There are three modes. And the glide mode is meant to be for the slower folks. Not the slower folks, I would say. To keep it economical. To keep it, not so efficiency. Keep the efficiency of the bike. The glide mode is good. But believe me, you need the combat mode sometimes in traffic to, get on that pickup. Get on that this thing. You left behind, yeah. The glide mode is not that great. I mean, and there's a top cap for the glide mode. I think the top cap is around 65 to 80. And the top cap for the combat mode is touching around 80 to 100. And the ballistic is obviously way beyond that. The ballistic mode goes up to 155, which I will touch. I have done 120 for sure. But 155 is not the kind of roads that I get to. I would 155. All right. I wish that sometimes, using that road just makes me want to I wish just for that. I wish the commute would have been. But I want the commute to become shorter. Yeah. Too big, I say. Takes me almost an hour. Or even the video you see, this whole video is about my commute from my home to my workplace. Maybe someday I'll showcase a journey to you about the places and names that I'm traveling through as well. Yeah, the pressure of the wind made the camera come down a bit. There you go. There you go, my guy. All right. I guess this is it, folks. We are almost at my workplace. Thank you for watching, whoever has watched me. And I will see you in the next one. Like I always say, stay human, stay humble. Bye-bye.